Situated high upon a bluff in Jefferson City, the Missouri State Capitol sits alongside the Missouri River, which once served as the main line of transportation for lawmakers and other visitors to the state capitol. Completed in 1918, this Roman Renaissance-style building is the third to be built on these grounds. The first capitol was built in 1827 and the second in 1849. However, both buildings were destroyed by fire, first in 1837, then again by a lightning strike in 1911. Approximately 4,650,000 bricks were used to build Missouri's current state capitol, which cost $3.6 million to construct. Construction began in 1912, and in 1917, occupants started to move in. A statue of Thomas Jefferson towers above visitors' heads when they enter into the building through two 13-by-18-foot bronze doors. It is said these are the largest bronze doors cast since the Roman era. The third floor of the state capitol holds both the Senate and House chambers, the Hall of Famous Missourians, and the House Lounge. The Senate chamber is the center of activity for the 34 lawmakers serving in the upper body of the legislature. The large and lofty room features 16 richly veined marble columns. A handcrafted dais is the vantage point from which the presiding officer directs debate and maintains decorum while the Senate is in session. The dais is encircled by a wraparound desk that provides a work area for the Secretary of the Senate and the Secretary's staff. The President's chair features three-dimensional renderings of bears to complement the Senate clock located above the dais. 34 desks, original to when the Capitol was completed in 1917, dot the Senate floor. Both the dais and the desks are made from American walnut. Key periods of Missouri history are depicted on four murals and a painted glass window featuring the landing of Hernando de Soto, the first European to set foot on Missouri soil. The murals depict Daniel Boone at the Judgment Tree during Missouri's colonial period, Thomas Jefferson greeting Meriwether Lewis and William Clark during the state's territorial period, Francis P. Blair's speech at Louisiana, Missouri during the Civil War era, and Senator Thomas H. Benton's speech at St. Louis during Missouri's era of westward expansion. Inspirational quotes are located in between two sets of murals, and a tasteful combination of classic millwork and intricate bas-relief, a sculptural technique, is found throughout the Senate chamber. Opposite the Senate is the House of Representatives, in which 163 members make up the other branch of the legislature. 12 noble columns line each side of the chamber. 163 identical mahogany desks are neatly arranged on the floor of the House. The dais is a brilliant example of architecture and workmanship, with richly carved engravings that feature the state seal and the official state motto. The speaker's chair also features hand-carved renderings of two grizzly bears, which represent bravery and strength. The glowing colors in the large mosaic glass window above the speaker's desk portray the glory of Missouri in peace. This work by H.T. Schlottermont of New York pays homage to Missouri as the start of the westward expansion in the United States. A vast painting by Charles Hofbauer called The Glory of Missouri in War depicts the unquenchable fire of Missouri courage and the strenuous activity of Missouri efficiency. It was donated by France to honor a Missouri battle unit from World War I. Both works of art portray the glory of Missouri in both peace and war. On each side of the lofty room, 10 beautiful stained glass windows represent the greatest characteristics of democracy, including liberty, equality, law, justice, fraternity, progress, honor, truth, virtue, and charity. Located in the rotunda between the two legislative chambers on the third floor is the Hall of Famous Missourians. This collection honors individuals who have been recognized for their outstanding achievement or contribution to the Show Me State. This ever-growing collection contains a collection of bronze busts that depict these famous Missourians, with the first, Samuel Langhorne Clemens, a.k.a. Mark Twain, inducted on September 8, 1982. Every bust holds a plaque describing each of these notable citizens' accomplishments throughout our state's history in areas such as entertainment, science, literature, art, the military, and business. Perhaps one of the most visited rooms in the Capitol is the House Lounge. This room contains the famous mural, A Social History of Missouri, by Missouri-born artist Thomas Hart Benton, one of the most notable artists from our state. His namesake, his great-uncle, was one of the first two U.S. senators elected from Missouri. Before the room received its masterpiece, legislators used the lounge as a place to congregate since they did not have their own offices at that time. Today, with the exception of meetings scheduled by lawmakers, the lounge continues to remain open to the public. Benton unveiled his realistic interpretation of Missouri's social history in December of 1936, which features Jesse James, Huckleberry Finn, the Pony Express, the Civil War, and many other people, places, and events that helped shape Missouri into the state that we know today. More than 25 years after the murals were finished, they were restored to their original state and are maintained with the help of proper air conditioning units and moisture controls in the room. Visitors notice the story Benton tells in his famous work by moving their eyes from wall to wall. The north wall features the pioneer days. The east wall shows Benton's depictions of politics, farming, and law in our state. And the south wall showcases the growing metropolis of Kansas City and St. Louis. At one time, a group of lawmakers wanted to paint over Benton's masterpiece, saying the subject matter did not represent Missouri. However, the proposal to destroy the murals never came to fruition. Today, the artwork is estimated to be worth millions. Down one floor, several executive offices are home to certain statewide officials, ranging from the governor and state auditor to the state treasurer and the secretary of state. The lieutenant governor's office is located on the first floor. Missouri is only one of a handful of states that house statewide officials in its Capitol building. 41 half-moon-shaped paintings, or lunettes, also line the hallways of the second floor. Most of these decorative paintings, which illustrate Missouri's resources and history, were installed between 1920 and 1922. Two of these lunettes are thought to play tricks on the eyes of those who look at them. The Artery of Trade features the Great Eads Bridge over the Mississippi River at St. Louis, and Reclamation in the South showcases the fertile lowlands of southeast Missouri. Both paintings give the optical illusion of a changing perspective while viewing the artwork from either direction. The first floor of the state capitol houses two museums. One features the state's history and the other its resources. These museums offer visitors an impressive collection of exhibits portraying the state's natural and cultural history. Exhibits include History Hall, which features many artifacts from the Civil War, the Missouri Veterans Gallery, which contains rotating artifacts from the Seminole War all the way to Operation Enduring Freedom, Resources Hall, which showcases the interaction between the state's natural and human resources, and Foundations Gallery, which displays exhibits on Missouri's state government and the buildings that have served as Missouri's capital. Nestled in the middle of these two museums and right below the Capitol Dome is a large seal of the state wrought in bronze. The Great Seal of Missouri was designed in 1822 by Judge Robert Wells. The emblem brings together significant symbols reflecting Missouri's past, present, and future. The Latin verse on the bottom is the state's motto, "Let the welfare of the people be the supreme law." The Roman numerals for 1820 indicate the year Missouri began operating as a state, and the large star surrounded by 23 smaller stars signifies Missouri's 1821 status as the 24th state. The state capitol is surrounded by works of art. Two stately fountains flank the sidewalks that lead to the front of the building. The Fountain of the Sciences, which focuses on geometry, geology, chemistry, and astrology, and the Fountain of the Arts, which features architecture, sculpture, painting, and music. A great relief commemorating the signing of the treaty by which the United States acquired the Louisiana Purchase is located on a bluff between the Capitol and the Missouri River. It was fitting that the group depicted in the relief, including Thomas Jefferson, was cast in bronze since his acquisition of Louisiana led to creation of our state. Located directly in front of this relief is a spacious fountain that contains fabled creatures of a different time. Centaurs and sea urchins, which are prominently displayed in this water feature, were imagined to exist before our state was inhabited by man. The pediment over the main entrance to the Capitol is symmetrically composed, on one side, light, art, learning, and agriculture, on the other, justice, order, law, and commerce. Below this peak, colossal bronze figures on each side of the grand stairway in front of the Capitol symbolize our state's great rivers, the Missouri and Mississippi. The female figure on the west end features corn, wheat, and the fruits of the earth that represent the great Missouri. The male figure on the east with the rudder of commerce represents the mighty Mississippi. On the very top, 260 feet above the ground, stands Ceres, the patron goddess of agriculture. In her left arm, she bears a sheaf of grain, and her right hand extends outward in a perpetual blessing. One of the newest additions to the Capitol grounds is the Lewis and Clark Trailhead Plaza. In 1804, the Corps of Discovery set out for a journey that would forever change the landscape of the United States. To honor the Lewis and Clark Trail through the Capital City, a monument was created to commemorate the historic journey. In June of 2008, a 4,000-pound statue was unveiled featuring Captains Meriwether Lewis and William Clark, York, Clark's servant, George Quilliard, the hunter and interpreter, and Seaman, Lewis's Newfoundland dog. The statues took nearly 7 years to complete and were created using the help of live models and photographs. With a century's worth of bricks and mortar and priceless art within and surrounding her walls, Missouri's Capitol building has a unique American story to tell, a story that values every region, every group, and every person in this state. And the story of Missouri continues to be written today by new men and women, sons and daughters of the Show Me State, with new ideas to develop, to preserve, and to illuminate. Here, visitors from around the state, the country, and the world can see for themselves the beauty and vast history the state capital and Missouri have to offer.